fine. Four type hair blows in the wrong direction, it's gonna get tangled. So it, like, that was a little cry cry about mine. I really did.
Hey everybody, it's CeCe. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video on me doing a cherry Lola treatment on my hair. This is something that I did frequently last year and I really did find it benefiting my hair quite a bit, mostly to attack my frizzy roots. The first ingredient you're going to go in with is some full fat Greek yogurt. Next ingredient you're going to add in is some baking soda. This is going to open up those cuticles to help them be able to accept some of those amino acids that we added in, and then follow that up with some molasses. Molasses is an ingredient you don't need, but it definitely helps with moisture. Then I'm just going to mix this thoroughly until it is equally combined. It is normal for it to fizz up a little bit from the baking soda reacting.
Okay, you guys, so you're gonna apply this to clean, dry hair. I actually washed my hair yesterday, and then I decided to apply it today. I just prefer to break up, you know, my wash day when I'm doing treatments, because it can be overwhelming and tiring to do everything all in one day. You guys, my hair feels so incredibly dry just because there's no product in it. I'm just gonna kind of section my hair off a little bit. You definitely 100% are gonna want a towel or something. I even have one down here, because it's really messy. So treatment is definitely really good for frizzy roots. That's like the main reason I started doing it. However, it does have other benefits as well. I used to do it really regularly, and honestly, you guys, my hair loved it. So I do wanna start doing it more regularly again. I'm just gonna apply this, you guys, root to tip, focusing a little bit more on the roots if you have frizzy roots. And my roots are a little frizzy, but I mean, I'm also just starting to accept that frizz is natural. I'm just gonna turn on some Degrassi. I'm applying it on dry hair right now, you guys. I'm honestly, it's been a while since I've done it. I'm trying to figure out if it would be, I feel like I applied it on damp hair before and my hair just reacted a little bit better. But when you have to think about the cuticle of your hair, if it's full of water, then there's not much room left in the cuticle for it to accept other products. So that's why I'm like trying to figure out what the best way is, but we'll see how we go. Cause as I'm massaging it in and piling on the product, it is taking it in. Also will help tremendously, you guys, if you make sure your hair is detangled beforehand. I detangled it yesterday, but fine. Four type hair blows in the wrong direction, it's gonna get tangled, so I'm not that concerned about it. So I'm saturating the hair, you guys, pretty good. Finally, my hair is starting to curl up a little bit, reacting to the wetness. Low porosity girl here, so my hair takes a little bit longer to accept product and to actually take in moisture, hydration, so. As I get closer to the center, you guys, I'm gonna apply a little bit more heavily. My hair at the crown of my head is definitely more thick. The curls are more tight, so definitely wanna focus more product there. I'm gonna try some water. I just feel like it's just going to tip. If you have low porosity hair, sorry, Degrassi's on in the background, my hands are messy, do warm water. It will help to open up the cuticle a little bit. Just make your hair a little bit more accepting of the products that you're trying to apply. Stay hydrated, folks.
okay, this is what my hair is looking like with the treatment applied everywhere. It does weigh down your hair a bit, which is completely okay since it's going to be rinsed out. Next, I'm just going to apply my two caps because this is the best way for me to get all of my hair inside the caps. I like to use two, and then follow that up with a heating cap that I got off Amazon. I just throw it in the microwave and it warms up for about an hour or so for best penetration. I didn't end up using all of the product, and yeah.
So I'm going to go probably sit outside because it's a little warm as well, just to help trap some of that heat. And I will rinse it out, and I'm not sure. I'm gonna see how my hair feels before I decide if I'm gonna deep condition. I might just use regular conditioner, help detangle it, because I didn't detangle it well enough yesterday, to be transparent. So yeah, I'll see you guys when I get back to rinse it out. Post shower, whew, y'all. Honestly, okay, so when I was rinsing it out, my hair felt super, super soft, and it even felt really super duper defined. And like at my roots, you know how when you get, if you've ever gotten a perm before, when you get a perm, the one that makes your hair straight, it makes your roots feel like really soft and like you can really like, it tames your roots, and that's what my hair feels like, you know, you guys, like my roots feel super, super soft. And I remember like in the past, this is really why I liked it for my frizzy roots. I don't really suffer from that now, but honestly, my hair feels really nice and soft, especially at the roots. And I think that little conditioner was just what it needed, what the doctor ordered. Guys, it like, that was a little cry, but like, I really did like that treatment. Like my roots just feel so soft and looks cry, but I'm gonna style it. I'm not gonna film that, but I just wanna show you my final results. Overall, I really, really loved the Cherry Lola treatment, and it's definitely something, especially coming, you know, as we're kind of rolling into fall, and we're going to be moving into winter. I want to make sure I'm doing everything I can to just take good care of my hair, address its needs, and I think I need to get back to doing these more, but I swear I need another haircut, and I just cut my hair a couple weeks ago. Some of my ends were just being irritating when I was trying to, detangle them, but I will show you the products I'm gonna use to style my hair. I'm not gonna film styling it because that's a whole nother video, but I'm gonna try a little bit something a little bit different. I'm gonna go, and this is all Camille Rose, actually. I'm gonna try this today. I'm gonna be using, the first product I'm gonna be using is their macadamia rice milk and macadamia oil leave-in. This is really thick, so I'm gonna go really light on that, you guys. If you don't know, I have low porosity hair, so lots of heavy products back to back, it just pills where it doesn't really mix well and it won't work well on my hair. And then I'm gonna go in with the Camille Rose twisting butter, which, you guys, this is really, really great for moisture, and it's actually like super duper thick, pretty thick. And then I'm gonna finish it off with the marshmallow and agave leaf extract curl maker. This is probably one of the most well-known products by Camille Rose, and I do really like it. It's a lightweight gel, offers definition, but not too much crunchiness. It feels so soft. Conditioner, I think, is definitely a must. Deep conditioner will probably be amazing. Just helps to soften the hair and add that moisture back in. But the definition is like out of control. And I definitely will credit it to the Cherry Lola treatment. What I like to do is let my hair dry as much as possible. I'll probably sleep with it like this, and then I will puff it up tomorrow. So worth the effort, but whew, that was a lot of effort.